So let us look at this unique property called reflection property of the parabola. So this property is going to be unique, and we'll also see that this property is actually used in lenses as well. In physics, basically, you'll be using this property directly. This property says that the tangent bisects the angle between the focal chord through P. So the focal chord through this P is this line SP, right? And the perpendicular from P to the directrix. So this perpendicular from P to the directrix is this PM. So the angle between this and this, which is this angle, that's bisected into two thetas by this tangent. I'm not proving this property right now, but it's very simple. Let me just redraw it in front of you so that you understand better. You have a parabola, you have a directrix. Pick up any point, draw a perpendicular, take the focus, draw the focal chord PSM. It'll have some angle 2 theta. If you draw a tangent at the point P, then that tangent will split it into theta and theta. That is the property, right? So let us see how we can use this property. So because of this property, what happens is, in lenses you will see, which behave nearly as a parabola, or in mirrors also, which behave nearly as a parabola, a ray which comes parallel to the principal axis, it reflects and passes through the focus. I believe you would have already studied this in your 10th. So these mirrors nearly behave as a parabola. Let's see why that happens. So now that you know that this angle is theta, let's see what happens here. So this proof property I'm not proving right now, but I'll show you how this leads to this, right? But this is the property. This is the property that you need to remember. So you have a normal through this. This normal is 90 degrees. What is this angle then? This angle is 90 minus theta, isn't it? Because this whole angle that you see, this whole angle is 90. A part of it is theta. So this remaining part is 90 minus theta, right? So this angle is 90 minus theta. If I have a ray which is coming parallel, so then this line and this white line, they become vertically opposite. This angle and this angle, they become vertically opposite. So this is also 90 minus theta, because this angle was 90 minus theta, right? This is also 90 minus theta. Also, here you have a theta, and this whole angle is 90. Why? Because this is a normal. This white line is a normal to this blue line. So because this white line is a normal and this part is theta, this remaining part will be 90 minus theta. So if you can see what has happened here, you had a normal like this. A ray which came parallel as 90 minus theta, after it hits the normal, it becomes 90. It still gets reflected by 90 minus theta. So the ray which comes, let me just trace the ray for you. So this is the ray which is coming with angle 90 minus theta. It's striking the normal here, and with respect to the normal, it is getting reflected by 90 minus theta, and it is passing through the focus. So that's why every ray which comes parallel will pass through the focus, and this will be 90 minus theta, 90 minus theta. Or what I mean to say is, whatever this angle will be, the same will be this angle, right? So this is what I wanted you to know about the reflection property of a parabola. So this is actually the property, and from that, this will happen. So let's move on to the next subtopic.